major concerns over the AstraZeneca vaccine.
The vaccine chosen to be the mainstay of Australia's efforts to defeat COVID-19.
There's a growing list of European countries suspending the use of the AstraZeneca vaccine.
Overnight, Germany, Italy, France and Spain joined the likes of Ireland, Denmark, Norway and a handful of other EU nations in halting the rollout. And other countries are following suit. It comes after Oxford AstraZeneca advised of more than 17 million people vaccinated in the EU and UK. There's been 37 reports of blood clots, but Britain's backing its vaccine.
We continue to be very confident about the programme, and it's great to see it being rolled out at such speed across the UK.
And the WHO says there's no established link between the vaccine and blood clots.
The experts are looking at the data. The rates at which these events have occurred in the vaccinated group are, in fact, less than what you would expect in the general population at the same time.
But the overseas suspensions are rocking the boat here. On order, 54 million doses, 50 million to be made in Melbourne. Now there are calls from some quarters to pause it here too.
Given that we are in a country that does not face an imminent risk of coronavirus spread, surely the prudent approach here is to suspend our rollout and just take heed of the evidence that will emerge in coming months.
These comments from Senator Canavan are dangerous, they are divisive, and they further undermine a vaccine rollout that is already way behind schedule.
But the Morrison government is standing by the vaccine.
I remain confident in the AstraZeneca vaccine, that it's safe, and that there is, at this point, no evidence that it causes blood clots.
The government clearly, unequivocally, absolutely supports the AstraZeneca rollout. Clearly, unequivocally, absolutely.
Well, Rob Grenfell is the Health and Biosecurity Director for CSIRO, who conducted the preclinical testing of the AstraZeneca vaccine. So he knows what he's talking about and he joins us now. Rob, Senator Canavan saying we should hit the pause on the rollout for the moment. Should we be?
Look, Australia's in a precarious situation with regards to coronavirus. We've been so fortunate here with regards to how it's been controlled by our borders, we're an island, and the quarantine and also public health measures. We need to immunise this country as soon as possible so we can reopen the borders and re-establish ourselves globally. Now, we do need to listen to our regulators with regards to what's a problem. Now, the European medical regulator and the WHO have both said this vaccine is effective and there is no evidence the side effects that they're investigating at the moment are in fact caused by this. And that's what our TGA is looking at the moment too.
But with so many EU countries pressing pause though, is it a conversation that should be had in Australia?
Well, when we're vaccinating at this such a global scale, we will see untoward effect or unexpected effects. Now, we need to work out whether those effects are caused by the vaccine or whether they're in fact actually just associated with the timing. Got to understand that so many therapeutics we use day to day have side effects, and we actually accept those side effects when we look at the therapeutic benefits being greater than any of those effects. I really want to come to the figures on this one because the European Medical Authority said this morning that of the reported clotting cases, 30 up against the 17 million doses given, that they're investigating this, but they're actually not saying that there is in fact actually a link, and this may well be an association, and I think that's what the findings will come up with.
So all that I accept is true, but nonetheless, when you've got countries that desperately actually need the vaccine, right, like these are countries that are in the middle of waves, and they've got every incentive to push the vaccine forward, they're not. So what is the explanation for that?
Look, at this stage, they've taken a very cautious approach and put it on hold. Our regulator has been looking at the evidence and the advice from the European Medical Regulator and the WHO and has made the decision that no, they will continue to proceed until, in fact, the results of this investigation have come forward. So one could perhaps say that it may well be a hasty decision by many of these countries.
Because it is an interesting decision given how many people would be dying from coronavirus.
Yeah, you can say it's cautious to pause it, but it's cautious Like it could be dangerous to Paul.
Yeah, look, I mean, I think in one sense, the CDC in the US released some pretty startling figures about your chance of death in certain age groups in the US. And so they've got a lot of data now, and it's actually very accurate. If you're over 75, a 1 in 9 chance of dying if you contract coronavirus. If you're over 50, it's a 1 in 90 chance of dying from it. That's not just hospitalisation, that's dying from it. And if you're over 30, it's a 1 in 900 chance of dying from the coronavirus. It's a serious disease, and it's a very serious decision to make to stall or slow down vaccination.
So, Rob, let's say something changes and there is a quite a serious problem with the AstraZeneca vaccine. What other options do we have here in Australia?
In Australia, we have Pfizer, we have Novavax being supplied towards the end of the year. AstraZeneca, at the substantial numbers, will need to get the first course of vaccines into us. There's a global shortage of vaccines, and we don't have a choice. But if the AstraZeneca one is shown to have problems, which I don't believe it does, we actually do have other options. In the future, the science has been done that, in fact, actually allows us to say with confidence that we have Generation 2 vaccines in the pipeline already.
We'll just have many million vials to do something with, Rob. How many did we order?
I've lost count of how many we've ordered.
I think it's 50 million, isn't it? That's a lot of vaccines.
What can you do with 50 million vials of stuff you don't want, Rob?
Well, the good part is that we haven't got 50 million at this stage. We've ordered it. They're being manufactured. But the point there is the excess stock. And again, I'm certainly very confident that the AstraZeneca vaccine, the way it's been performing in the UK has been astounding, with a 94% decrease in hospitalisations. I'm having sleepless nights thinking about how long we delay. We've got problems with our neighbours with New Guinea having an outbreak at where they are. We have continued incursions from our quarantine and return travellers. We need to immunise this country as fast as possible with vaccines to reduce this problem.
All right, Rob, we'll have to leave it there, but thanks for joining us tonight.
It's been my pleasure.
It's interesting what the WHO has said there about the number of blood clots. I think it was 37 amongst 17 million is actually lower than the number that would naturally occur within that population.
Ooh, yeah.
So there's a fear there, but that would be happening anyway amongst that number of people.
Which is why I think they think it probably isn't linked. But the whole thing raises interesting mental exercises because you focus on the risk of the vaccine.
Of course.
But what we kind of were talking about there is the risk of not having it.
But is that because, obviously, the people who would die from having corona versus people who die from having something a government has administered to you?
Yes. So it's much more striking and it's scary in that way. But what's the less risky option that you take in this situation?
We were all obviously focusing on different things because I was thinking earrings. That's right. What you could do with 50 million vials. See, your earrings, that could be four little vials on each side there.
Vial.
Oh, that's, and you know what? I was about to make a very serious point then about how this pandemic has seen us start to, you know, assess risk in a way that we wouldn't have, but then, you know, Tommy talks about earrings. So I got nothing.
There you go. Fair enough.
Sorry, Liz. I'm so sorry. I always go last. I'm so sorry.
From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.